know what I would do without mummy, cook too, and carry on. Sometimes the pillow, and on the side, spicy mummy cook. I don't know what I would do without mummy's cuckoo and kangaroo. Sometimes it's quite fancy. With something too, I don't know what I would do without mummy's cuckoo and kangaroo. I would like some now. Would you like some too? Of mummy's cuckoo and kangaroo. Yes, I don't know what I would do without mummy's cuckoo and kangaroo.
Thank you. only blackboard. We need to have fun and see how I can cope with being treated like a no-one. Why come me back here, and then they will hold me back? Why make me the colour of darkness, and they put the things of that? When I hear the word blackboard, and I think of what it means, I feel the place and dirty hands. What can look pink and quick? Why did you give me a thick nose and lips, and the pinky nasty hair, that makes me stand out in crowds, that makes quite people stare? Black is the colour of bruises, and some will die in me. Black is the colour of darkness. Why make it the colour of me? Why is my bone structure so thick, my hips and cheeks so high? Why colour my eyes like big black holes and not the colour of the sky? Why do people think I'm trouble and why I'm always being used? Why do people see my skin and think I should be abused? Well, please answer my question. Why do they only see my skin and then immediately hate me when they don't know? And why let my own people mistreat me? They don't like my hair or my skin. They say I'm too dark, too rough, that my bumps, too fat, or too thin. But wouldn't it be better if we could have a chance to redo creation so we all look the same? Thank God we blind. Oh, my sweet and precious child. What makes you think I've called you hard? There is no need to be alarmed. Why did I colour you black? I never coloured you at all. I just made you one of the mightiest nation of all. I made you the colour of rich dark soil or black gold, that precious oil. These things that people need to warm their homes to grow to be. I made you the colour of coal from which beautiful diamonds are made. I made you the colour that is strong, one which will never fade. All colours of the rainbow are found in all our nations. When you combine these colours, you become my gracious creation. Behaving like an animal before, I created beauty and him. I am the shepherd who walks over the land, and I will always look over him. You are the colour of the sky at midnight, the stars that shine shine in your eyes. Look for the smile behind your tent, then you'll see why your cheeks are hung. I made your lips so thick and full, because there's spirits in my kitchen. They lay on the lips and I'm the like mystical, magical whispers. Your structure is strong, your bone structure thick, in order to last for all time. You carry my truth within you, you're a messenger of mine. So next time you see your reflection, very carefully what you see. I didn't make you in the image of darkness, I made you in the image of me. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And I think that's how it should be. We have one or two issues, obviously, around black people in Britain. And what worries me most of all is that the third and the fourth generation of black people still have some problems which we need to address in this country. And some of the ways in which we're going, as a councillor, because Mary asked me to come up here to say a little bit about my role as a councillor, but just briefly.
2 minutes.
Of a late, what I've been trying to do, because you see, what we have nowadays, I think we're going away from a class system to a classless system with an underclass. And what's happening, white and black people in the pockets of looting to fall into the underclass areas. And Manchester is one of these underclass areas. And it has 30% of our black people in that area. And like Marsh Farm, as well as other places in London, what we're trying to do is to build up a community spirit around it. And for that, we are actually pumping in money to help to build a community spirit among the whites and blacks. Make it a proper integrated society and community for London. And we have spent about, we are spending up to £50 million in the Looping the Ashburn area to do just that. Help them to get employment, help them to get training, help them with their education, their housing, and all these sort of issues. So I'm proud here tonight to see that the very things that we're trying to do for the whole of Luton, this is a macrocosm of what this is all about. And that's why I say I'm really proud to be here tonight. And I hope this spirit continues, not just once a year, but try and make it as often as it can. Because once we get people together, talking together, enjoying themselves together, enjoying the food that is here tonight, and look at this, the spread of flowers. I mean, all these things are part of your culture. And I noticed the theme tonight was about culture. And it's understanding a multicultural society. That's what it's all about. Thank you very much.
Right, now we've decided, and the lot falls on me, obviously. right at the beginning, Rose told us a story about the daughter. 10 years ago, when I started as a Methodist minister, I had, within a fortnight, two families who had the same experience as Rose and her husband of losing a baby through what is now known as SIDS. Sudden Infant Death Syndrome, which is the posh name for a cop's death. It's been in the news fairly recently, and we're beginning to understand a little bit more about Sudden Infant Death Syndrome. And this evening has been with that in mind. And so I want to thank Rose, first of all, for sharing that story with us, and you will have the opportunity of helping towards the support of families who have lost a child very early on, very suddenly, for apparently no reason at all, no obvious virus, bacteria or anything of that sort, but just a sudden death. And before you go, you'll have the opportunity of helping and making a gift towards SIDS, Sudden Infant Death Syndrome. Secondly, thank you very much for sharing with us something of your culture. It's been nice and it's been a very great pleasure for me to be here to hear about your backgrounds, where you come from, what life is like. I think it's been very much a Caribbean evening inside. I can't say anything about the weather outside. Certainly not once you get outside that door. But it's been a great privilege to be here to share that with you. I still get confused between the islands, so please do sort of forgive my ignorance. I can never remember which island you come from, any of you. It's just a great pleasure when I've been down at the Oval and we've played you at cricket, and you've won more often than we have in recent years. But it's been good to be here to share with you. But before we go, let's just give thanks to God for our evening together, and then I'll close with a blessing. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that you made us all like yourself. Many, many differences, many, many experiences that we all share, your gifts given to us. And we thank you that we are beginning to learn how to share one another's gifts and one another's cultures. And we thank you for this evening. We thank you for those who have taken part, those who have spoken to us in sung and danced parts. And now as we go to our homes, we go asking your blessing to be with us this evening and during this night. Keep us safe, we pray, and bless us. For we ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.